All right, folks, welcome to Nino's Corner.tv. I am joined with Rosangel Perez once again, and this time Ron Partain. We're doing a roundtable here. We're going to be talking about October surprise, everything heating up, everyone's preparing. There seems to be some kind of takedowns happening. The P. Diddy stuff is escalating. World War III is escalating now. Erica Adams is indicted. What the hell next is going to happen? I mean, anybody's guess. So thank you, Ron, and thank you, Rosangel, for joining me. This is going to be an exciting podcast, folks. But first, I got to do it. Home title lock, folks. Attention, American homeowners. You already do so much to protect your home, but there's a hidden threat you might not even know about, and it's called title theft, and it's happening in the millions. Did you know that homeowners nationwide have over $32 trillion in home equity? With everything going on in the state of the U.S. economy, home ownership is more challenging than ever, and title theft is one last thing you should have to worry about. That's why you need protection from the crime that the FBI calls house stealing, and they do this by cyber, and then you don't even know what happens to you. Where the equity in American homes is the target. If your title isn't being monitored, scammers can transfer it into their name, take out loans, and your equity could be wiped out without you ever knowing. The best way to protect your equity is with triple lock protection from our friends at Home Title Lock. Triple lock is 24/7 monitoring, alerts, and restoration services. Sign up today using the link in the description or go to HomeTitleLock.com and use the promo code David, not Nino. It's just David this time. And you'll get your first 30 days of triple lock protection for free and a complete title scan of your home's title so you can make sure your home hasn't already been compromised. This is really, really happening. I just interviewed the guy. That's HomeTitleLock.com. Use the promo code David to get started. This is a serious threat. It's happening in the millions in America. You don't even know it. You just get a foreclosure sign on your door, and your house is gone. Crazy. Crazy times we're living in. Everything's crazy right now. Everything.
Amen to that.
It's just the news we're about to bring right now is crazy. So are you guys ready to hit this?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's roll. All right. So let's start first with Eric Adams. Eric Adams, Mayor Eric Adams is indicted. Right here. Boom. New York City Mayor Eric Adams indicted following a federal investigation, sources say. It looks like to me, guys, that is Rosangel still in here? She's gone.
Looks like she's gone, but she'll probably be back.
Yeah, she'll be back. But it looks like to me, she just disappeared. Looks like to me, like the takedowns are happening. Mm-hmm. It looks like to me, if there's any inclination or any sign of this, it seems the P. Diddy thing, Eric Adams, Kathy Hochul's, what is it, editor in chief?
Mm-hmm.
She's been taken down. I mean, this is getting a little wild, don't you think, Ron?
Yeah, I agree. She just texted me and she's coming in. She's coming back. So, I'm seeing, I know Juan often says that there's not going to be a secret rapture. But you know, in this particular case, I kind of feel like we might be seeing something akin to that. I don't know. I can't say it for certain, but I am seeing there's a lot of stuff that's going on right now that would lead me to believe that there are arrests happening behind the scenes right now, maybe in private. So
I think there has to be. It seems to me like there's moves being made right now. But as all this is happening, it's like the escalation of World War III is happening. It seems to me like, more of the Diddy stuff. It seems like everything's just happening. The climax is happening right now going into October. And I've always said October is going to be like the kickoff. You know, this is going to, every October of every year has been red October, a hot red, hot October. Yeah. I mean, last year it was the thing with Israel, right? And now this October, you could bet it's going to be even crazier than last October. Don't you agree?
Oh, yeah. And it's, you know what? It's so crazy to say that, we're literally almost a year away from 10/7. To me, that's insane that it happened. It's like, wow, time just flew.
Already.
It's crazy. But on that note, we are seeing so many things happen right now. You know, you talked about, building up into a crescendo. I don't even think that I think that what we're witnessing right now is like, we're still in the calm. I don't even think we're even near storm yet. It's like, maybe a little bit of breeze and then some drizzle, but in terms of like hurricane, no.
Yeah, but we all see it coming. We all Correct. See it coming. Some of them are feeling it right now, like New York Mayor Eric Adams, who's been indicted following a federal investigation. Sources tell CBS New York. I heard he could be arrested by tomorrow.
That's what I heard as well.
Yeah, the move comes on the heels of several investigations involving the mayor and members of his administration. The various probes have been playing out over the course of months, starting in November 2023, and heating up with a flurry of subpoenas in recent weeks. Adams responded to reports of the indictment on Wednesday night. My fellow New Yorkers, it is now my belief that the federal government intends to charge me with crimes. If so, these charges will be entirely false. Yeah, buddy. Based on lies, but would not be surprising. I always knew that if I stood my ground for all of you, I would be a target, and a target I became. So he's going to play that card, I guess. We all know
he
what
can
New
try
York
to
is.
Play that game. That's just because he plays the game doesn't mean the people are going to buy it.
This is going to get bad. I mean, for months, leaks and rumors have been aimed at me in an attempt to undermine my credibility and paint me as guilty. Just this past week, they searched the home of our New York police commissioner looking for documents from 20 years ago, just 1 week after he joined my administration. Enough. I will fight these injustices with every ounce of my strength and spirit. If I'm charged, I know I'm innocent. I will request immediate trials so the New Yorkers can hear the truth. New Yorkers know I'm sorry. They know where I come from. I have been fighting injustice my entire life. The fight has continued as your mayor, despite your pleas where the federal government did nothing as its broken immigration policies overloaded our shelter system with no relief. I put the people of New York before party and politics. Now, if I am charged, many may say I should resign because I cannot manage the city while fighting the case. I can also understand everyday New Yorkers will be concerned that I cannot do my job while I face accusations. But I have been facing these lies for months as I began to speak out for all of you and their investigation started. Yet the city has continued to improve. Make no mistake, you elected me to lead this city, and lead it I will. I humbly ask for your prayers and your patience as we see this through. God bless you, and God bless the city of New York. Thank you. This guy is so full of shit.
He's a Democrat. He's a Democrat.
Yeah, that city's a hellhole.
Not even that. But, Democrats, for the most part, and I hate using that term and putting people into a box, but for the most part, people on the Democrat side, they refuse to invoke God in prayer in anything that they do. So whenever they do that, that means that they're like in serious trouble. And how I
you're
see
right.
It.
That he's like, you never see an atheist in a foxhole, right? Isn't that what they say?
That's right.
When in danger, they go to God. Everyone does.
Yep.
To me, I'm wondering, with P. Diddy and everything happening right now, the timing of this going into November has me really thinking. I'm like, is this all connected maybe? Could we be seeing the first dominoes fall that we've been desperately waiting for?
I absolutely think so. 100%. I mean, everything that we're seeing right now is like, you've got that. You've got all the stuff with the different groups of people all over the country, the people from down in the Caribbean that allegedly are doing things to animals, domesticated animals. You've got I saw that there was a thing in Alabama where there was a city council meeting where the citizens came to talk to him about a very similar problem, and it's like the city council just completely shut the meeting down.
I saw that.
Yeah.
They didn't even want to hear it, right?
No, they're like, deal with it. We're done. This meeting is over.
We don't even care anymore.
Yeah, we don't care.
I mean, and that shows you just where we're at in this country, where everyone's at.
That's in South Alabama. I mean, you want to talk about flyover country and hardcore conservative values? Yeah, you don't want to mess with those people. I mean,
everyone's just taxed out. Like, everyone's just politically 100%. Exhausted, and they're just like, let's get it on. Like, we're now there where it's like, enough talk. We've passed the press conference. We've passed the weigh-ins. It's time to fight. You think that's what people are
okay,
asking?
So let me tell you. I want to tell you two stories. One happened to me today. I went to the grocery store and I was buying a couple things, and I was wearing a Trump shirt, and the meat counter guy came out and he saw my shirt and he said, "I like your shirt," and I'm like, "Oh, thanks." And I says, "Like, it's going to be."
Told him you like his pants.
No, I knew what he was referring to. I knew what he was referring to. But anyway,
sorry, all right, folks. Sorry.
He said, "He's like," I say, "it's going to be an interesting couple months, you know." And he's like, "Yeah." I think it's going to turn out really good for us, you know, come November. And he said, "I agree." He says, "There's no way that they can kind of take it from him, and if they try to." And these are his words. He said, "If they try to, we have better aim."
Oh my God, dude! You know, everyone's going there. I went to go get a haircut today, and the hairstylist next to my barber was like, "All right, we made a bet, right?" And he's like, "You said it. You said he thinks that Kamala is going to make it. He has no faith in Mr. T or any kind of operation or anything happening. He thinks they're going to take it and she's going to get in. So I have a bet with her." The only thing that I didn't include in the equation was her maybe being installed before November as some kind of event or threat might be happening to America. She gets installed the 25th, uses the 25th. Biden gets six strips of gear. I think they're that desperate, and I think they might try to maneuver her in before November. What's your thoughts on that?
You mean the 25th Amendment?
Something
thing?
Like that, or something happens to Biden, you know, who knows? And then she's already in there. They got her locked in.
Basically,
and then whatever happens,
she becomes the president, is what you're saying.
Right. Right. I've been thinking about that. And
I hadn't considered that. I have to be honest. I hadn't considered that. But I hear a lot of people saying that Jill Biden is running the White House, or is running the country.
She's conducting a lot of the meetings. Yeah, she's done a few of them already. And Biden says, "Go get him, kid." Like, okay.
Yeah, that's reminiscent of Woodrow Wilson's wife.
It's crazy. You know,
okay, so Woodrow, when Woodrow Wilson's wife, she basically ran the country at the end of his presidency because he had a stroke. And that was the entire reason why they put the 25th Amendment in place, is as a result of that.
Really?
So, yeah. So
that was why.
That was where the 25th Amendment came from, because Woodrow Wilson's wife was basically acting as president for the final like 18 months of his presidency.
That's crazy. That was the origins
Woodrow of the
25th Wilson
Amendment.
Was the one that signed in was for the Federal Reserve.
Federal Reserve Act, 16th, 17th Amendment. He was there when we went
that
World War One. Yeah, that was him. So, and anyway, it's crazy.
Well, look at this. I mean, and I did a show on this earlier. U.S. gears up for homeland defense as Russia-China warships reach Pacific. A Russian-Chinese flotilla sailed toward the northern Pacific Ocean on Monday, while the United States deployed two warships for homeland defense operations to protect Alaska. Like, this is getting...
I think that's just bluster. Looks like Rose Angel's coming in. I'm not worried about a military confrontation with either Russia or China. I'm not worried about it at all.
I'm not worried, but I'm concerned. It's definitely, I think we're heading towards that.
China,
Juan has said many times, "Hey man, there could be a nuclear scare." He really firmly believes that's what
I agree.
We're heading.
I don't disagree with
how
that.
How do you not worry about
there's,
it?
Because there's a difference between a scare and an event. A scare is like a Cuban Missile Crisis type moment where everybody's on a razor's edge before some event occurs. All right, an actual event where you have a detonation of a nuclear bomb.
Well, that could happen.
I'm not as concerned about that. I guess I don't have any control over it. So why would I? I'm not going to worry about it. If it happens, it happens, and I got to deal with it. But until it happens, I'm not going to live my life as though it did happen.
Well, Rosangel, thank you for joining us once again. I know your computer froze up, right?
Yeah, at least I froze with a smile. At least that's what I think. Hello,
Hello.
everyone. It's good to be back with the fam. And hello, Ron. Nice to
Nice
officially
to,
meet you.
yeah, exactly. I'm super, super excited.
So, what are we looking at here? Rosangel kind of puts these together for me and my podcast. She's been an amazing help. Everyone knows Rosangel. She's been a producer for MTV, and she's worked with Diddy, which is absolutely
Wow.
crazy to me. So right here, I'm going to go ahead and click on the first one here, Rosangel. Obviously, it's telling us Eric Adams becomes first sitting New York City mayor indicted in historic federal probe, claims feds persecuting him over migrant crisis. I mean, we all know he's part of the game. I mean, he's going to play this card of I'm innocent. I mean, New York has turned into be a hellhole, right? I mean, you live there, Rosangel.
And we were just at City Hall yesterday because of Varmagate. I won't get into it too much here. I would just say to the community, explore that hashtag. But it does have to do with how he kept certain policies in place after de Blasio. And he had
Look at this. Hold on.
moments.
Just look at this guy for a second. This, I mean, look what he is. I mean, wow. Anyway, go ahead. I'm just, ugh.
Well, look, he is a walking meme. He is better than SNL. He writes his own memes. He says that he is the best mayor of the globe. And the way he reasons that is because New York is the best city in the whole globe. And he's the mayor of New York City. And that means he's the best mayor of the globe. That math doesn't make sense to me. But whenever he would get criticized, he would just kick back and say, it's that they can't handle all this chocolate leading the city. Now, me as a Latina woman, I do appreciate that, he wanted to install the first, black and brown in certain positions of leadership because we really hadn't seen that in the city. But, the conversation is, it's always, is it the right person? Is it a qualified person? Is it someone that can do the job when you're in a leadership position that requires, having managing all of these different nuances in a city, one has to be prepared. And I don't know if he really knew what kind of situation he was putting himself in. He had an opportunity, but he chose to create his persona as a nightlife mayor. I want to just take a moment to shout out the former NYPD that have been exposing this corruption, like John D. McCary and Sal Greco and Eric Dim, and Sal Greco called it. We've been smelling it. And is there a connection to him and Diddy? A lot of people are
That's
rumoring that in the street. We
wow.
don't
So
know.
that's what I was gonna ask you. That was gonna be next. I mean, a lot of rumors that he could, that's the whispers I'm hearing. No validation on that. It's allegedly. Could he be connected to Diddy? Because he is the nightlife mayor, right? Adams will surrender to authorities early next week, sources said. I've heard tomorrow, as early as tomorrow, so I'm not sure what
Oh,
you
it's
all.
well, we're not sure. I know that, that we were sort of placing bets on the back end if it was going to come down to Thursday. Some thought that it would be as late as the following week, but we were kind of, this is sort of like the announcement of the news breaking today.
Here, I'll play it.
Wednesday night, the indictment has not been unsealed. Rumor is, and it looks corroborated right now, that the indictment will be unsealed tomorrow, Thursday morning, with the mayor actually surrendering next week. But Mayor Eric Adams appears to have been indicted here in New York City. Stay tuned. We're going to be following it.
You know,
Just Fox News has just confirmed Democratic New York City.
I find all this, you know, everything that happened to Trump, and now it just seems to me like it's happening to all of them. Like the boomerang is beginning.
Boomerang. That was exactly the word I was going to use.
Right? I mean, isn't this, is this seems like the boomerang effect, right?
That's what it looks like to me. I'm gonna ask Rose Angel, what do you think?
We've been smelling this. And I have to say that there have been many different approaches to wanting to dismantle and unveil Eric Adams. And so which approach really worked? We know that there have been active movement on the de jure end to, you know, hold him accountable and, you know, and hold him to his oath. Shout out to them too. I have to say I'm really proud to be a New Yorker, even though we are experiencing one of the most corruption filled weeks that I can attest to in my life.
Well, you don't remember what it was like in the Koch years before Rudy Giuliani was mayor. I mean, the 90s, New York City was just, I mean, it was a hellhole and crime was through the roof. And it was when Giuliani came in, that was when he stopped they started, what was it called? Was it stop and frisk or the broken windows or broken windows policing or something like that? But I've heard Bongino talk about this quite a lot when, you know, I used to listen to his podcast that, you know, New York City was just really dangerous. I don't know if it's as dangerous today or if it's more dangerous today bad. Compared to then.
I was just there.
Yeah, I don't know. I think I've spent all of about 24 hours in New York City. So
yeah, every city is spiked right now, man. Every city.
Well, I'm close to Los Angeles, and I spend a fair amount of time in L.A. And it's, you know, downtown L.A. is. I was there in my convertible with the top down not too long ago, and I was nervous. Honestly, I was apprehensive. I wanted to get the hell out of there.
It says
and
here,
I think that this is all into sort of like interconnected. I'm sorry to cut
I think
you
it has me. To be, right?
Yeah, it is. Yeah. I how can it not be?
Look, it says here, it says now Adams and Diddy could be cellmates in the same federal prison. Wow. I know I'm not supposed to laugh, but come on, I find this to be hilarious. It's the irony of this, right? He's giving P. Diddy the keys of the city, calling himself the entertainment bad boy, and then he's the bad boy of politics. I mean, they obviously have a relationship. Okay. This could be connected.
You know what I see here? This is just another form of like I gave the Presidential Medal of Freedom to Biden.
Yeah, exactly.
Videos have been playing on the Jumbotron for TSX Broadway, and the crowd waited. Then around 11:30, the doors opened for the mayor and the artist.
The bad boy of entertainment is getting the key to the city from the bad boy of politics. I want to thank y'all for this honor and just recognize.
And now they're going to be cellmates. But this is insane. I can't believe the times we're living in. I'm telling you. Trump had to go first. That's the way they I believe the way they strategized this, they orchestrated this, and now that's out of the way, and here we go with the rest of them. What do you think, guys?
Well, excuse me, if you don't mind, I'll go first on this. I think that's absolutely accurate. You know, in the drops, it talks about POTUS will be insulated, and I believe that what the period of time that we are in right now is that insulation period. And of course they could have multiple meanings there, but you know, Mr. T is insulated right now because he's not in a position where he has any authority, you know, at least in the public sphere. So
look at this.
What are your thoughts, Rose Angel? If you want to give them.
Well, I have so many thoughts that we could be here all day. It's just that besides it being a connection to Diddy, even if it's not a direct connection, there's something that reminds me of why we're in there on Tuesday, which I don't want to expound too much here because of the censorship stuff. But the expose with that happened. One thing that people kind of didn't connect is that this man was having sex parties supposedly in a dungeon by Wall Street.
Jeez. Mm.
So then, then all of a sudden this man that he was connected to.
Wait, Who was having the parties? The mayor or Diddy?
No.
Whoa.
Yesterday, we were at City Hall putting pressure on the Adams administration because of his refusal to hire back the thousands of city workers who said no during the 2020 season, right?
Mm-hmm, right.
To mask it for
our
audience.
Yep.
So there was an expose done by Crowder, blah, 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 blah. That blew a whole bunch of things opened. In that expose, that you hear someone who was directly in charge of defining the policy during 2020 for New Yorkers. So while he was mandating mandates, he was having sex parties.
Damn.
And he says in a dungeon. So, of course, this was under the de Blasio administration. But then it connects to Adams because Adams continued it. Now, how... I have a feeling that all of this is in a weird way interconnected because there were no bid contracts that were accepted. There's the funneling of people that were, you know, that just keep coming through the border. There's his strange relationships with foreign nationals. And so and then just all of that is kind of connected. Now, how is it connected fully to Diddy? We don't know, but maybe it's just that there was corruption at the top, mismanaged in all senses of the word. So even if it's not directly connected, it's still connected in the regard that New York is in unveiling a lot of corruption.
Because here, Diddy's former bodyguard has said in multiple interviews that Diddy had blackmail tapes on not just celebrities, but also politicians, members of royal families, and even preachers. Preachers, man. Can't wait till that comes out. I don't think it's only celebrities who's going to be shook, Gene Deal said. He had politicians in there. He had princes in there. He also had a couple of preachers in there. As I've been saying, the Diddy revelations will lead to high-profile politicians like Bill and you know who else. I can't say their names on this, believe it or not. And they're front here, so... This is, I can't even say her name on here either, but I'll play a little bit of this.
I don't think it's only celebrities going to be shook. He had politicians in there. He had princes in there. He also had a couple of preachers in there.
Wow. I mean.
Well, you've heard the story about like T.D. Jakes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. TD Jakes. I mean, this is getting crazy.
Listen, I just texted you something, Nino. I'll send this to you as well. Let's see. Where are you? Come on. There you are. It says FBI whistleblower testifies to Congress, advises to be prepared due to corruption.
Wait, what is this? What did you say that again?
It says FBI whistleblower testifies to Congress, advises to be prepared due to corruption.
Like he's giving a threat to Congress?
No, like he's telling people in Congress and the people of the country to be ready for chaos that's going to ensue because of the exposure of corruption.
This also makes me go back to Trump's Truth Social post where he put a checkmate symbol.
Mm-hmm.
I have to wonder, is this what it is? You know, he's had an attempt on his life twice now. I don't think they're fucking around anymore, dude. I think there's, you know what, they might even be speeding up the process. What do you think?
I agree. But I think it's been, I think we've naturally been, I mean, we're going downhill. And we're starting to get into like we're starting to build up speed.
Yeah, absolutely. It's like the cascade is happening right now. Mm-hmm. So what's this, Los Angeles? Sean Diddy Combs' lawyer blames Costco for 1,000 bottles of baby oil he buys in bulk.
Well, you know, this guy's
so perverted, man.
Well, this is kind of like what I've been contemplating. Why 1,000? why does this number keep popping up? Does this mean something bigger than what the story is representing? Because out of all the things, and I understand, I'm aware of saying this with a media lens, that people will grab what's most sensational about something and just keep highlighting it.
Mm.
But it just seems a little bit weird to me that we keep talking about the 1,000 bottles of baby oil and
lube.
Well, I mean, they're just talking about his freak off parties. I mean,
no,
I
know,
all...
but just the number and the exaggeration.
That's a lot of baby
why?
Oil,
yeah, fuck? It's like.
I mean, did they have like a slip and slide?
I heard so many stupid things, like maybe he used it to fill a bathtub.
Maybe, I don't
make
know,
it steamy,
man.
I don't know.
I've heard these parties are crazy. I mean, they are absolutely crazy. All right, hold on 1 second, Los Angeles and Bon, 1 second. Folks, got to do the mid-roll here. Listen up, everyone. I want to take a moment to talk about something important that affects so many of us. Do you constantly feel exhausted, weighed down, and struggle to get through the day? The culprit may be right under your nose, a sluggish, overworked liver, and God knows I banged up my liver. The reality is your liver is under constant attack from processed foods, environmental toxins, GMOs, microplastics, fluoride, and so many other things that we still don't even know about. Over time, this takes a serious toll, especially like me, drinking so much alcohol back in my day. In fact, a staggering 100 million Americans now suffer from an overworked and sluggish liver, according to American Liver Foundation. That's nearly one in every three people. If you're tired of feeling sluggish and ready to reclaim your vitality, I highly recommend giving your liver the support it desperately needs with Liver Health Formula from our sponsor, Pure Health Research, folks. This cutting-edge supplement combines 11 powerful, clinically proven ingredients to detoxify and rejuvenate your liver at the cellular levels. Liver Health Formula's natural ingredients and nutrients are designed to revitalize your liver, helping raise energy, optimize metabolism, and manage your weight. This company has already helped more than 2 million Americans. It's time you joined their ranks and got back to feeling your best. I've been using it. I've been feeling damn good, but I use it because I've been paranoid about my liver with all the damage I've done to it, not to mention not just the shots of tequila, but the liver shots I've taken in boxing. As a special offer for my listeners, you can try Liver Health Formula and get a free one-month supply of nano-powered omega-3 to support your heart health as well. This is an exclusive offer for my audience. Visit getliverhelp.com/Nino. Hit the link below, folks. Get started on it and start feeling your best. All right, I'm going to get back to the stories here. This is so wild to me. I don't even know where to speak. Here we are. Here it is. Boom. Baby oil. So I just think they're freak off parties. I think everyone's involved. There's what, thousands of people at these things.
Well, did you still have that link that I sent you about the white parties?
With Leonardo DiCaprio in it?
Yeah.
I'd have to find it.
No, I can send it to you again real quick.
Send it to me.
Yeah, the internet is vomiting pictures right now.
I mean, everything's coming out. It's just getting so crazy.
This guy's gonna lead to everybody.
I mean, this guy was, I mean, like what we talked about in the last show, like Hugh Hefner in the Playboy Mansion. This guy was that of the entertainment industry. These people had no idea that they were being filmed for blackmail. All of them, right? He was getting dirt on all these people. I guess that was his role.
Yeah.
Here you go. Pretty sad. And
check
shocking.
Your email.
I'll check it, but listen.
Your parties are the hottest ticket around.
They won't even give me a permit for the parties, man. They don't want me to throw the parties no more. But we ain't going to stop. We're going to keep on having fun, bringing people together from all walks of life. You're going to hear about my parties. They're going to be shutting them down. They're going to probably be arresting me, doing all types of crazy things just because we...
So he's predicting his arrest right here. This is crazy. This is pretty wild.
We want to have a good time. You know, whenever you bring up a different element into people's environment, things that broaden people's horizon, people get intimidated. There's a lot of people out there that feel intimidated by it. It ain't nothing but break it down racial barriers, break it down generation barriers, people from all walks of life. Ron Perlman talking to Jay-Z.
Man, he's even throwing Jay-Z.
Can I say something about that? You know, when he's talking about breaking down age barriers and breaking down gender barriers or color barriers, stuff like that. But most notably, age barriers.
Oh, did you say age barriers? You said that, right?
He did. Did he not? Did I hear that right? Did you hear that, Rose Angel?
Let's replay it then.
Yeah, let's replay it. I thought he said age barriers. Because to me, listening to it with the lens that I see the world with now, him saying age barriers, to me, that screams of wide variances in age gap, if you catch my drift.
This one here, right? Yeah, he did say age. I mean, let's see. I think you're right.
Around. They won't even give me a permit for the parties, man. They don't want me to people together from all walks of life. You're going to hear about my parties. They're going to be shutting them down. They're going to probably be arresting me, doing all types of crazy things just because we want to have a good time. You know, whenever you bring up a different element into people's environment, things that broaden people's horizons, people get intimidated. There's a lot of people out there that feel intimidated by it. It ain't nothing but breaking down racial barriers, breaking down generation barriers, people from all walks of life. Ron Perlman talking to Jay-Z.
Generation barriers.
I don't think he said it. Would be it, right?
But that would be generation barriers would definitely be bringing people of different generations into the same space.
Wow. Yeah, you're right. Absolutely right.
I mean, and what is a generation? A generation basically is 40 years.
Oh, my God.
That's essentially a generation is defined as 40-year period.
Yeah. That's pretty, I guess that's, yeah, man. I mean, that's what it would mean to me.
Mm-hmm.
It's exactly what it would mean to me.
So if you're breaking generational barriers, then that means you've got people in the same room that are 40 years apart. And if somebody's 50, then
I mean, yeah, that's what it means. That's obviously what it means. You're right. Yeah. Sean Diddy's list of Hollywood celebs, part of this Freak Off session, Jay-Z, Beyonce, Jennifer Lopez, Usher. Jeez, man.
Allegedly, right? Because a lot of articles are capitalizing on clickbait right now.
Yes.
And so we all have to be careful with that. And so I don't know. I suspect that as this gets crazier, it might be a little harder to
suss. Uh-oh, Russell Brand's name's in there.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh.
Well, you know what? Just because he once was, if you've seen what he's doing now.
Yeah, but
I get
it. Doesn't matter what he's doing now. It does not matter. It doesn't matter what any of these people are doing now. It matters what they did then. Sorry, your past comes back to catch. Okay. I mean, we all know this.
Yeah, I mean,
it's
listen,
just what it is. I hope not. I love Russell Brand.
If they're guilty of doing things that are
the minors, you know,
just because his name is there doesn't mean that he's guilty of doing some of the heinous stuff. It could be that he's, you know, maybe got compromised in some way, but we don't know. You know, he could have engaged in just normal, consenting adult stuff. Right. I don't know. I'm not. I guess I'm just trying to be. I'm trying to give the benefit of the doubt. So maybe
absolutely,
I should.
Absolutely, because we have all been in parties, situations, yeah. Conferences, when we take a quick little
people
picture,
party, man.
And depending on how it's taken, it could look like something that wasn't.
Right.
Right.
And so we have to make sure that people keep that in mind. It's amazing to always look back at things and have this amazing
insight. Here's my thing. I don't care what the hell they did at white parties. I don't really give a shit at all. As long as minors weren't involved.
Right.
You know, I don't care if it's whatever it is. I don't care if it's two dudes, a woman and a guy. I don't. They're adults. They make their decision. That's up to them.
Consenting adults. Consenting
right.
adults,
it's just,
period.
It's just when you are abusing minors. And like, I'm talking minors. You know, like, I don't. I mean.
Well,
it's,
you know,
there's a lot of gray area here, too, man.
When you're talking adults, and I don't mean to cut you off, brother, but when you're talking adulthood, you know, you could have a 10-year-old child that is on his own, basically in foster care or or yeah. maybe even, you know, and who has to live in a world where he is, he's a master of his destiny at a young age. Okay. By the time that that kid reaches 15 years old, he's a hell of a lot more of an adult than people who maybe have lived at home with their parents.
Yeah, but he's still college. A minor.
I get it, but I'm not talking about that. I'm just talking about the attitude of because you're saying, well, what if he's 17? What if the person's 17?
Right, right. What if one is 21 and the other one's 17?
Right. That's technically statutory, right? But that doesn't necessarily. Right. But if that person is really an adult in mentality, then you know, I mean, because it comes down to mature. Adulthood is not exclusively by age. It's also I think the maturity level plays a significant role in adulthood.
I agree, but I think, look, dude, the number's 18, right? I mean,
I get it.
Just you don't go over the line.
I'm not disputing that. I'm not disputing that at all. Not disputing that at all.
I mean, I understand what the both of you are saying, especially when we look back at the long history of Hollywood and mm-hmm. and the music entertainment. I mean, can we think about Elvis and how old was Priscilla?
Priscilla was 14, right? No.
Yeah.
Like, why was it okay back then? Or Jerry Lee Lewis married his 13-year-old cousin.
Right.
That's insane.
You know, when R. Kelly married Aaliyah, and then you know we know what happened afterwards, but she was not an adult. So yeah, there's all these things where it feels like the culture was in some of those situations they were more lenient, and maybe because people died earlier in the earlier times, and so people have more growing up to do. Right now we're in a baby culture, in a sense, you know, we're not maturing as quickly, and we also don't,
I think I
it's to, gonna to, come to, out to, wrong so I'll just land my plane.
Go ahead. To piggyback on what you were saying, Russ Angel, I think that we are we're living in a time where people are soft. And you know, this what's happening now is they've literally made it almost so we accept without questioning anything. But see, I still think that there's that fundamental gut instinct within all people, regardless of however much they want to make it like what's the word I'm looking for, like acceptable in society. There's just a segment of people that are not going to be accepting of it at all, even as much as they try to shove it down our face. Like, you know, if you look at community stuff, they started pumping that into our movies.
Yeah, be careful. TV shows. Be careful with that on here, man.
Okay, in the 80s. That's all I was going to say. They've been pumping that into us since the 80s. So the stuff that they've really been starting to get more aggressive with the I don't call it the child stuff, more, you know, within the last 10 years, because they've been TED Talks where they talk about you know, people that have a mental condition that leads right. to them having that desire. Yeah. So I mean, they've really been trying to push it on us hard, but even as hard as they've been trying to push it, there's still inside of us, we have this inherent instinctual belief that no, the children are
right off limits. Let's talk
especially
about this for a second.
Innocence.
Let's talk about this for a second. Lawmakers propose you brought this up earlier, Ron, and this is what I'm leading to. Now that we kind of see, I don't know, these kind of takedowns, that's what it's looking like to me. I'll be more confident in saying that if I see a few more people fall in October. I'm going to be like, all right, it's on. A few more, you know? But it seems to me as that happens, the escalation of World War III is coming. It's happening. It's happening right now. Lawmakers propose amendment to address mass casualty event amid rising political tension.
Mm-hmm.
A constitutional amendment has been proposed by members of the House of Representatives to address potential mass casualty event and discourage potential attacks and assassination attempts against U.S. lawmakers. According to the Washington Post, two Republicans and two Democrats in the House of Representatives have proposed a constitutional amendment that would provide continued representation for American citizens in the event of a potential mass casualty incident by allowing House members to be quickly replaced. Huh. The lawmakers have argued that the amendment would discourage people from committing violent acts to change the House's balance of power. So it's like a fail safety, right? As you know, it's a safety. We've seen a 300% increase in threats against members over the last 7 years. Jeez. So, I mean, but look what they're doing. You know what I mean? Like, to me, it's almost like the Americans are pissed. People are mad. I mean, what's happening right now is so off the charts. I can't even believe that we are living in this time.
I think it's an extraordinarily exciting time to be alive, frankly. I'm not worried. That doesn't mean that I'm not concerned about certain things happening. But, you know, I look at this in amazement and wonder and just in awe that I have the privilege to be alive at this moment in time and to watch this stuff.
Trump will start World War III. It says party autographing the bombs to be launched at Russia. Remember, they were telling you, Trump's going to start this war, that war, World War III. And look what they're doing right here. They're autographing the bombs to send to Russia.
It's insanity. These
people are so sick, man.
Wait a second. Read the article at BabylonBee.com.
Yeah.
So this is Babylon Bee.
Yeah, but this is satire, but this is really a real picture. They were doing this. This right here is satire, but they were signing these
munitions.
Yeah. Yeah.
Are those munitions being sent to Ukraine or what?
I guess for Ukraine to use. Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is Babylon Bee, but they're actually making a joke. But this really happened.
Mm. That's crazy.
Yeah, they seem to be amplifying the chatter. But I will say that when I'm outside and I take my little meditation strolls that I like to call my New York City walks, it feels pretty good. It feels like we're at the turning point and I could see a lot of different layers of humanity awakening in different ways, which is beautiful. But at the same time, I am concerned living in New York City. I have to tell you that there's been weird glitches happening and like with things not updating. With my sister got stuck in an elevator. We went, at the same time, we got into another elevator and it was saying was going to go up and then it went down. Weird things have been happening with the subway too, where all of a sudden all the stops are updating and all of a sudden they stop updating and today the train skips stops and I'm like, is this happening intentionally or is this like a glitch? Is this gonna be is this testing ground? Is this gonna be a train accident, God forbid? I'm not trying to put that out there. 911
outages has been happening all over the country. Have you guys heard about that?
There have been massive delays on the train. It's just getting insane just to even get to and from. And then to top it all off, there's been a lot of like young activists who just pop up and create massive mayhem within their protesting. So, yeah, be free to protest. I love to protest, but, you know, endangering putting other people's lives in a chaotic state is not okay.
This was posted on Ayatollah's website, apparently truly terrifyingly chilling. This is by Mike Lee. This is crazy if it's real, man. I think it is. This is I just don't even know what to think about it. So they posted this. Is that actual footage of Trump?
That's CGI.
Right? But I mean,
that's CGI.
But the fact that they're posting this is crazy. But that's not real footage of Trump golfing, right?
No, that's CGI.
So, I mean, this is a threat against Trump. Obviously, look, who's really in charge of this? I think we all know. We can't say it on Fluff too, but they're going to blame Iran, right?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
That's what this looks like to me.
This is all propaganda to make it look like it's Iran, is my opinion.
I agree.
We know who it really is. So they're beginning. They're sowing the narrative, right, Ron? They're beginning the narrative to make people like,
this is narrative shaping, predictive programming at its finest.
Right.
I don't believe any of this.
Who's really in charge of putting this out there? So when it happens, we'll all look at Iran.
The fifth generation worker.
Jeez, man.
Okay, so not to be a crazy conspiracy theorist, but was it there an article recently about, or not an article, news reports about exploding pagers?
Yes.
Yeah, that really did happen.
And so then I know it's not the same thing, but it's technology that's used for one thing being weaponized on your person, and all of a sudden, pew. And haven't we been hearing of people's stuff exploding on airplanes randomly?
That's pretty crazy.
I haven't heard that either.
I hope that's not true.
No, but not a pager, but something small. Like, I'll have to look. But you know when you're tracking stories and things keep popping up in your mind's eye as like, I don't know why I keep seeing these type of stories. And then the last little thing is that I remember, and I won't mention any names, I remember one particular billionaire who's now in locked up behind bars right now, but I remember one of the things that he was famously saying, and his people were saying too, is that there is a way for people to hack into even, I don't know, anything that could be, anything that we have at that smart could be weaponized against us. So when I see this, that's where my mind goes. Like, I know that's CGI, but a lot of weird anomalous things are happening. And also it reminds me of even some warnings that I've had in dreams, and other people who are friends of mine that have had dreams similar to that of technology or things that are not known to be one thing to be weaponized, to be used as another thing. It was almost like as a decoy in a setting where there's a large population.
I think this October is going to lead to so much more. Imagine if October is going to be crazy. Just how crazy will November be, then December, then January? I think the climax is going to be February, March. What do you guys think?
I think October is going to be the craziest month because of the...
I think November.
Yeah, because November 5th is the day.
I agree with Juan on this. I think there's going to be a pause and a halt, and it's going to be contested. It's going to be ugly. I think it's going to be a mess until it gets cleared up. You know what I mean? I don't see it coming off clean and smooth. I just don't.
Well, I don't know. I guess I do in a way, because I think that's going to happen, and a statement needs to be made. It's like, look, we won, and that's, deal with it. you're going to have to freaking deal with it. It's going to be like a rude awakening for the left to see the numbers of him winning. I think he's going to win
in an absolute landslide. So
I mean,
you see this being like 2016.
I see it being, yes, I see it being like 2016, but that doesn't necessarily mean that you're not going to have, once that happens, the country will kind of come together and everybody will be, you know, all the people on Mr. T's side are going to be like, okay, so this is real. I mean, we actually see like legitimate numbers here, even though there may be a couple of instances where they tried to do something nefarious, right? You got that. But that's when I think a lot of the placed assets are going to start to do their thing and cause chaos because they want to prevent the inevitable.
Right. And I agree with you on that. I think that window of October to, let's say, December, January is going to be pretty ugly in the sense of chaos. I think the immigrants, the whole thing, there's so many unknown factors that can just wild cards, you know. Damn, dude. I mean, it's going to get, I think we all know it's going to get bad.
Can I say one more thing about video? So one thing that I did think that was very accurate in there is these smaller countries turning to micro technology, call it drones or whatever, low intensity conflict, because they know that they can't take on the United States. They just can't take on the United States from a big standpoint. You know, I mean, think about the revolution. You know, one of the things a lot of people may not know this, when the British came over here and to fight the Americans, employed Indian tactics because they knew that they couldn't stand toe to toe with the British army. So they employed tactics that were
the Comanches.
And they would shoot the officers, which was not, you know, I mean, that was verboten. You can't shoot the officers. That's not a gentlemanly thing. You know, war was still chivalrous back then. And the Americans were like, no, hell no. And they would snipe off the officers. And then back then the British military wasn't trained to have the officers be not leading the men. You know, that was unthinkable.
That's unbelievable.
Right.
It was like a guerrilla warfare.
It was guerrilla warfare. They were using guerrilla warfare. Okay. So, and I, you know, bring it to, you know, to current day. Well, you think Iran is going to be able to take us on as a near peer? There's no, I mean, we have the largest military budget than the top six other countries, the next six countries combined.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, that we've got technology that nobody can even fathom that we have. So why, you know, number one, if they did employ techniques or tactics that would, they could feel like they could get through, it would be something along those lines. But this is what I ask. Who benefits? What do they benefit by taking out Trump? They don't benefit anything. Trump is their biggest friend. Yeah. He's Iran's best friend, because
I'm saying it's not going to be them. That's why I'm saying.
I know. I'm preaching to the choir. I get it. I'm just trying to articulate my point.
Right. Well, folks, I'm going to call it here. This has been a great podcast, Ron. Thank you for joining me.
Oh, thank you. Angel Perez. Sorry I overtalked you.
No. It's good. I'm just tired. Rosangel, thank you so much for joining me. Rosangel, where can they find you?
Thank you, everyone. Cafecito Break Cafe, CITO Break on social media. Thank you, everyone, for the subscribes, and thank you for this opportunity. It's been a great show.
Ron.
Thank you. Find me untoldhistory.tv. Takes you straight to my Rumble channel. Right now, I'm kind of focusing, and I focus on history, the untold history of the country, and geopolitics as well. But I really try to go back and paint the picture as to why we are in the storm that we're in today. And it's not something that's just, you know, 10, 20, 30 years old. This goes back a long time. And that's what I try to illuminate for people. So, and I'll touch on some topics that are curl your tongue, I promise you.
Oh, you're talking about your OnlyFans?
We weren't supposed to talk about that, man. Come on. You promised.
Oh, boy. All right, guys. I'll see you, man. Have a good night, folks. I guess I'm going to premiere this tomorrow evening. So, all right, guys. Later. We're out.